Hi, I'm Sarah. In this lab activity, we will type the blood samples found at the scene of a crime and compare them to the victim's blood type and the blood type from five suspects. In this video, I'll show you how to test the blood to help solve the mystery. We test for blood types by adding a serum to the blood. If the blood cells contain a protein that an antibody attacks, the cells will clump together and the blood will look lumpy. We call this agglutination, and it can be seen with unaided eye. Anti is short for antibody. So, blood type A, for example, would have A proteins on its cells. But blood type A has antibody B, or anti-B, in its serum. The A antibodies can attach to the A antigens on the surface of the type A blood cells, so agglutination occurs. Likewise, the B antibodies can attach to the B antigens on the type B blood cells. Type AB blood has both antigens on its cell surface, so agglutination will occur with both antibodies present. And since type O possesses no antigens, agglutination will not occur when either antibody is present. For safety reasons, we will use fake blood in this lab rather than real blood. Although it is safe, the fake blood will permanently stain clothes, so handle it carefully. For each blood type test, you will need a clean blood typing card, a slide, a dropper bottle of anti-A serum, which is blue, a dropper bottle of anti-B serum, which is yellow, two toothpicks, and a sample of the blood you wish to test. First, shake the blood sample vigorously. Place two drops of the blood on the slide, one under anti-A and one under anti-B. Now place one drop of anti-A serum on the blood drop on the left-hand side and one drop of anti-B serum on the blood drop on the right-hand side. Be sure the anti-serum bottle does not come in contact with the blood, as it will contaminate the anti-serum for future use. Hold the toothpick in a flat position and thoroughly mix the blood and the anti-serum on each side of the card, using a separate toothpick for each. Press the toothpick firmly against the slide as you spread the sample out in a circular motion. Continue stirring each mixture for about 1 minute. Place the used toothpicks immediately in the trash, rather than on the table to keep the area clean. Examine the samples for signs of agglutination, a clumping or residue on the bottom of the slide. This clumping means that the antibody in the serum reacted with the protein on the blood cells. This is what happens inside the body when a patient experiences a transfusion reaction. Now let's take a look at the possible results that you may observe. For blood type A, we would see the blood agglutinate with the anti-A serum. Blood type B would agglutinate with the anti-B serum. It stands to reason that the blood type AB would agglutinate with both sera, and that blood type O would not agglutinate with either one. When you've finished, wipe the slide with a Kim wipe and throw the Kim wipe in the trash. You'll use the information you gather with the blood type lab to help solve the mystery. In addition to solving mysteries, blood typing can also help determine paternity. We discussed the genetics and the chemistry of blood typing in the screencast, Extensions of Mendel's Laws. Feel free to watch that screencast again if you need a review. See you in the lab!